So
nothing beats it any day.
Normal rock climbing is kind of an interesting term because there are so many different aspects of rock climbing, so many different disciplines. 20 years ago, what we consider normal, what how most people start rock climbing, is bouldering, and that didn't start picking up steam until the late 90s with the advent of gyms.
The gym culture also is different. There's so many facets of climbing. Like, if you're a super staunch trad climber, then it's definitely more of a lifestyle thing. But then, sort of, I don't know, since the 70s or something, there's been a lot more sport climbing. And then just recently, in the last like 20 years, there's been a lot of gyms being built and a lot of like young kids. At the gym that we go to, there's like a
new kids
climbing team for like 6-year-olds, you know? So it's just really changed. Yeah. It's a really changing sort of thing.
I started rock climbing beginning of my sophomore year. It's the end of my junior year now, so I've been climbing for almost 2 years.
And it's like one of my favorite ways of staying in shape. And I got really into it last summer. I was living in Lander, Wyoming, where like the Knowles base is, and I had all these friends who were super into it, so I got gear and I've just started to become obsessed a little bit.
I'm Sunny White. I've been climbing, my parents climb, so I've been climbing my whole life, basically.
I'm Erica Stemple, and I've been like only seriously climbing since for like a year and a half, 2 years. Not super long.
I'm Sarah Hsu, and I started climbing in the gym in high school and started climbing outside.
My name is Dan Leininger. I'm a senior. I'm the climbing wall coordinator, and I set the routes, a lot of the routes, and I orient people, and I run trips maybe 6 years or so, 6 or 7 years.
Probably 2 years now, a year and a half. I don't know, I came out here and a lot of people climb, and I started going to a climbing gym with one of my friends. And then I went outside a couple times and I got a membership and kept climbing ever since. It's definitely a social activity. It's definitely more social than like skiing.
Yeah, we definitely challenge each other. I think it's like mostly like self-challenging.
Okay.
Challenging yourself. But I don't know, it's cool to like be able to like see the progression and see yourself get better at anything. I mean, whatever it is, when it's rock climbing, you can do the same thing. You can, you know, see yourself, you know, struggle on a route for a really long time and then finally get it.
I think even in climbing comps that I have been in, it's just like honestly you work on problems together. You're like, oh, that holds there or whatever, and like it's not like someone would point out something to you that's obvious, like, oh, you have a foot below you. It's like, oh, you have a foot below you. And you're like, yes, thank you so much. And you just get to keep going and like work together, and it's really fun.
Well, at our level, which is a pretty recreational level, there's very little gender gap between the women who climb and the men who climb. At maybe the really upper echelons of rock climbing, there are marginally more men breaking barriers, but that really changes every couple years. Unthought of climbs are pioneered by both men and both women. And especially in my experience here, the women crush. They're oftentimes like, the strongest climbers at UPS are definitely two women.
I don't really know if any sport attracts me as a girl. I think that I'm just excited about climbing up rocks. I know I grew up going on lots of hikes with my family, and I would always be the one who was just like, boulder, and like just like climb up it and go crazy and be really excited. And then I realized that was actually a legit sport.
I would like to say that climbing is gender blind, just because the style of sport that it is, it's not something that you can just muscle your way up to the top all, you know, through for every route. There's girls here that are with us right now, and they can outclimb. I mean, one of the girl climbers here can outclimb any of the guys here, like no doubt. I think honestly, it's much more of a head game than it is like a physical sport. And so I think with that mindset of just like the mental game, it's very much so gender blind. I think there are those moments. I think especially when you first start climbing, it can be kind of embarrassing watching girls climb better than you, but it's definitely a humbling experience. And I think you get used to it. And I think in the climbing, especially in the climbing culture, you get used to, you know, a 12-year-old kid being able to climb better than you. You get used to, you know, you're not better than every girl that climbs. It's, you know, there's nothing like that. It really is just about how determined you are to climb. I mean, how much practice do you have? How much guts you have to make a big move that someone else might be afraid of. So I would say gender does not play much of a role in climbing culture, I think.
It has a lot to do with balance, and I think in terms of like men and women, women are like naturally a little bit like have better finesse. So I feel like a lot of girls are like better naturally at climbing, like when they first start, and guys are generally a lot stronger. So yeah, you know, like everyone, sure. Like everyone can climb well, whether they're strong or whether they're technical. So that's pretty
but
cool.
Definitely you get on climbs and they're like, yeah. Oh, this is a chick climb. Like, you'll just cruise right up. Yeah. Like, what does that
there's
mean?
This one route somewhere. There's this one route somewhere where they're all really hard, and then there's one easy one that's called the girlfriend route. That's the name of it.
Which
is kind of lame.
Yeah.
I raised that. 32.
There's also, I think, you see more guys out climbing mm-hmm. than girls. Like, I feel like.
Yeah. Here.
Other than you two, we've got more guy friends that climb than
girls. I would agree. But, yeah, that's true.
But I mean, that comes with, I think, any like kind of extreme sport. There's generally less women, which is unfortunate.
Yeah.
There are a lot more famous men climbers, but I think the women climbers definitely stick together. And I think, like, they hold their own, I mean, among the men. And
technique has a lot to do with it. Men, when they go climbing, just watching people starting, and in my own experience, they want to pull up on a lot of stuff, and I found that women tend to approach it as more, I want to say delicately, but using your legs more, which is a much more efficient way of climbing, and so it takes a lot of time for men to unlearn these kind of habits of pulling down, trying to do pull-ups, whereas women often have better form.
I would say I've mostly climbed with guys, actually, and it's super equal. I think even when you're better than someone in climbing, I think there are people who are super good and can get kind of exclusive, but I think the people I've climbed with, at least, are just really encouraging. I think it's exciting for everyone when someone gets up a rock, because everyone knows that they are like not as weathered, not as strong as the rock. And so it's just super exciting when anybody makes it up, and like when you can work together. I just think it's...
I think any girl out here can climb with the rest of them, and I don't think there's any like handicap towards one gender. I think they both share an equal fight. I mean, it's all about body mass index, you know. So it's like, if you're a small girl, you can throw yourself up a wall just as easy as, you know, Adam, who's here, that's, you know, 220 or something like that.
Oh, hey.
hey there. I didn't see you. Welcome to Route Setting the Band.